The name is Rohan Quine, and the main title of the book is The Imagination Thief. And there's also four novellas called The Platinum Raven and The Host in the Attic and Apricot Eyes and Hallucination in Hong Kong. So five titles so far, working on number six. Well, marketing works best with a sleek single genre, so for that reason I carefully selected three cross-genre categories for myself just to make things real easy for me. Their DNA is actually literary fiction, but there's also very much a touch of magical realism going on in them, and a dusting of horror, let's say. They are a love bite to the world. The world needs slapping across the face for treating people as badly as it does in many cases. I'm lucky just being able to sit here and speak, you know, with some vague coherence in, as I may be, but many people are slapped very hard by life in very many ways. And I think life sucks for doing that to people. I don't know why it does it to people. Nobody does know. None of us know, do we? But it does. Life really beats some people up, as well as elevating and embracing others. It's just this grand, messy, strange, glorious machine that we're in. And we better love it, because we don't have, as best we can, because we don't have too much choice over which machine we were put in. We were dropped into this one, whether we like it or not. There are some supporting characters that I don't have any part in. They were just useful to the plot, and in one or two cases I sort of took them from real life or melded people, different people in real life, into, you know, to make them. There's part of me in all of those. So there's a joyful, sassy, streetwise woman called Evelyn. There's big time part of me in her. And there's a depressive dreamer, quiet dreamer, who sits on her high-rise balcony alone, saying nothing, looking out, absorbing all she sees around her. She's somewhere in me too. I love her. And there are many other characters. There's a dark, fierce sort of character, all kinds of shades of characters. Light and dark and high and low, and you know, I'm somewhere in all of them, yes. It's a slow burn because of what I write, slow but sure. In other words, certain authors whom I greatly respect are writing for in categories where there is more of a ready-made community, or rather more of a to be more precise, a community that is more accessible through established, recognized channels. If you're balmy enough to write what can loosely be called literary fiction, that is less easy. That element of the task of doing what I'm doing here is less easy. It still can happen, but over a longer, slower, slow burn timescale.